All right. Opening gag. Funny opening segment. What should I do? Oh, I have a good idea. Oops. All right, note to self. The police don't think throwing rocks at retirement homes is funny. Hey guys, welcome back to the Devlog. Last time I had finished up some more enemy variants like the sleeper, police car, and marchers. These guys are great and all, but they look really stupid without animations. Especially the marchers. Stupid things. So one of the major things I focused on was actually giving these guys some animations. Now I already had animations for the police and charger, and apart from some mild changes, they're pretty much still the same. The car just has a few basic animation cycles going between a forward movement and a turning animation, with different states depending on how damaged the car is. The shielder does a little spinning animation when defending against the player, and starts flicking its warning light when all of its shields are inactive. The marchers are, of course, marching with various instruments. There is a drummer, a trumpeter, and a saxophone player. They're all led by the conductor, who I made blue, so he'll stick out. Lastly, we got the sleeper. The sleeper, of course, sleeps, but he has this adorable panicking animation for when you get too close. Like, aww, he's terrified for his life. That's adorable. You might have noticed as well that the player is far smaller than in previous videos. I actually re-rendered the player to be 200 by 200 pixels instead of 350 by 350. This allows more space for the player to see on screen and reduces the file size overall. Speaking of reducing the file sizes, I also made it so that there are less weapon-dependent animations. Beforehand, every weapon had separate sprite sheets for both arms, meaning that for every weapon, there were two player-sized sprite sheets stored alongside the player's main sprite sheet. That was about 14 different sprite sheets just to animate the arms across 6 weapons. Now there are only about 5 animations that require the weapon to be out, and instead of rendering both arms, I now just render the player's left arm and right hand in one sprite. It's mostly unnoticeable, but I do need to figure out a better solution for the current walk animation since it looks kind of stiff. I also changed the way a lot of the guns work. The thing is, almost every gun was exactly the same. Some did more damage, some had more ammo, but there was no real difference to any of them. So I decided to rework pretty much every gun besides the pistol and the turret. The shotgun became the shockgun. It stuns enemies for a few seconds at a time. The ripperfire became a flamethrower because, ripper fire, because the fire rips, it rips stuff. The snapper now has a bullet that, once it hits an enemy, can deal damage over time as long as the enemy is touching it. The missile launcher is pretty much the same, but now the missile will target enemies for a little bit, and the explosion now blasts enemies backwards. I'm also adding some new weapons, like this goo gun that slows enemies down when they touch the goo, and this gun that knocks enemies backwards when they touch the white circle. Last thing here is the tileset for World 1. A tileset is pretty much the same thing as a sprite sheet, but instead of being used for animations, it's used for setting down the environment in a video game. Think something like a top-down Zelda game, for example, where the ground is a flat object and you can divide it all up into little squares. Each of those is an individual tile, and developers will create a tileset to draw all those tiles from. These sets will have ground tiles, corner tiles, unique tiles for variety, all that sort of stuff. Since my game is 2D, it's easy for me to use Unity's built-in tiling tools to manage my current tile set and implement it into my game. Here is a quick example of what the finished product would look like with my current tile set. That's about all I've done for now. You know, it's pretty hard to develop games while in prison, so I'm just gonna wait out my sentence. Shouldn't be too long, I think. Just gotta wait it out.